specifically also wanted to talk about sleep. And someone asked me about what can you do if...
just check it's on. Yep.
What can you do if you're finding it difficult to sleep? Like if I get too much emotional buildup or anything, then it can get, or stress, then it can get more difficult to sleep. But there's a few things that I do for sleeping. One is several things I do. It's like, well, is there anything in my life that's creating stress or fear or anger or turmoil? Because I need to get rid of that and get to peace on that. Because otherwise, if I go to bed and there's a great anger or there's a great spiritual resolution that I haven't resolved, then it's likely that I'll wake up in the middle of the night with this kind of bubbling kind of thing that's unresolved. So, various things. I mean, I'm told, you know, I have a spiritual mentor called a sponsor. I might speak to them. Like, is there a way I can come to peace? Do I have to say something to release this situation from my consciousness? Or so that's one of those things. Like, do I need to make an amends or amend my behavior? That can be something. The other thing would be if I'm feeling a lot of fear or stress or anger, is sit with those feelings. This can be a great thing. Like if you can spend some time before you go to bed, and if there's any kind of feelings or anything, just feel the feelings without identifying or making a label, and feel them out until you get the sense of like you felt out anything that's disturbed you throughout the day, and that can allow you to have a peaceful night. So it can sometimes have the opposite effect. Sometimes if you do the feel the feelings before you go to bed, you have tons of energy. It's like suddenly, oh, look, I feel like I've got like hours of energy, because you can get quite energized when you do feel the feelings. Other thing I really like to do is listen to, I like Dr. Hawkins. I've got some audible things or some lectures of Dr. Hawkins. Or if you've got any spiritual teacher that you like, you can listen. That can often, because if the ego doesn't like something, it'll try and send you to sleep. So especially like, so if you put like something like, a, you know, 8 hours of A Course in Miracles, like the ego will go, I'd rather you slept than listen to that for 8 hours, you know. Or like Dr. Hawkins talking about the death of the ego.
Yeah.
You know, put the death of the ego on a loop. How to kill the ego. I mean, the ego will probably send you off to sleep with that one. It's like, you don't need to listen to that one for 8 hours, you know. How to annihilate the ego and become enlightened, you know, something like that. I've had compliments from my videos, like some people go to sleep with my videos. I take that as a big compliment, you know, I think that's a great compliment. But I also find that if you do that and you wake up in the middle of the night, you hear something inspirational and then you just doze off again. So I sometimes have it go on in the night, and I've had mystical experiences just by having a enlightened teacher go on loop in the night. But generally, yeah, just resolve any emotions or any conflicts. Usually if there's no emotions or conflicts, you do normally have a good night's sleep in that way. Okay.